To an entrepreneur is hard work, but it's worth it when it works.
You got your hands full every day like I do. You got kids, you got a marriage that you're trying to work, a business that you're trying to make work.
And finding time for the kids and keeping it spontaneous. But I was good last night.
Oh, shut up. Nobody teaches you how to manage a business or manage a relationship or marriage. Everybody's just trying to do the best that they can. The purpose of the show is to give you some tools on how to make the marriage and the business work. We don't do it perfect, but we're figuring it out. Woo! Welcome to the G&E Show, Wednesday at noon. You can always count on us. Take
so
it away,
good,
G.
So good, so good, so good to have you here. Hey, our number's 305-865-8668. 305-865-8668. Man, I am like...
You are jacked.
Dude, I'm tired, dang. Man.
Really? I would have thought just the opposite. You seem a little...
Do I really?
Yeah.
Well, you've been out shooting guns. You want to show them your little bruise on your gun?
No, that was a secret. You aren't even supposed to do that.
I sent her out yesterday. I sent her out with my boy Thomas, and I said, hey, Thomas, teach her how to use a Glock 26.
I wanted the little baby gun, but he wouldn't let me because you said no.
And I said, look, here's one. This is the only thing I need her to learn to shoot, man. And she came back 30 feet targets. I'm talking all kill zone. Everything from lungs to heart to just freaking chest damage. I'm like, that's right, baby.
Woo!
That's right. Okay. I'll make it. You protect it. I'll make it. You protect it.
I
what are
like
we talking
that.
About today, E?
Well, okay.
By the way, let me just excuse me, but... You guys on Facebook, please take the time to share the stream. Appreciate it. She knows more than anybody else. My ultimate thing is to meet as many people, influence as many people as possible, help as many people. What we're going to be talking about today is not a popular message. Elena's topic today is?
Well, Elena's topic today was how to handle jealousy. And guess what? 2 minutes before the show, Grant was like, oh, hell no. We are not talking about that.
Jealousy.
We're talking about playbook to millions.
I have
to find a way to squirt my topic in there.
She's like, squirt. Yeah. She's like, why in the insistence on money all the time? I'm like, folks, man, you guys clearly don't understand. I just finished talking to 35 people, Robert. You were on the call.
I was.
Dude, those guys don't know. Here's people with a wife and two kids, and they're not making enough money to take care of them. And they don't know they're not making enough money. I want to read this to you. And I'm going to tell you, this is going to be my legacy, okay? My legacy is what much as I'm known about sales, helping companies sell, convert. Dude, my legacy is going to be about showing people how to get their money right. Because nobody's telling you guys the truth about it, okay? In 2015, and I made this statement about 3 weeks ago, I said, we are entering into a major recession right now. It's happening.
I know.
You hear me talk to you all the time,
You've been
right?
saying it for 3 years, but when we got back from New York, really hammered down.
No, I haven't been saying we were entering a recession. I said,
we need to prep
yes. for problems because the economy hasn't changed. Now, and some of you have even commented to me, dude, why are you so negative right now? Dude, I'm not negative, man. I need to know where the target is, just like she did that piece of paper. I need to know what we're shooting for. You and I could actually make more money in a contraction. You could make more money in a contraction for your family and provide for your family than the other way around. I just want to give you these stats. This is right out of InfoWars, 58.
What is that? Info?
It doesn't matter. It's a negative station. But look, let's say half of what I share with you right here is true. Mm-hmm. 58 facts about the U.S. economy from 2015 that are too crazy to believe.
Oh, dear.
Now, this guy's into all these kind of freaking gold and silver pitches and food, you know, and you need weapons and you need food. I'm not talking to you about that, but I am talking to you about this. You need, right now, for your husband and the wife and the kids to be on one page. And the page needs to be the money page. There's no reason to go to work.
Mm-mm.
You need to go to work to prosper.
Mm-mm.
And we have this meeting every day in my office with my people. I'm like, look, you guys got to get your money right. Me and Elena want to help you. She's on the same page with me. Are you on the same page?
Oh, hell yeah.
Dude, she pushes me out the door into the elevator in the morning. Go to work. I'm like, no, I want to sleep in. Get your ass out of bed. Mm-hmm. Go make some money. Right?
Yes.
So why is it important to you, Elena? Tell everybody how you grew up.
Well, I didn't grow up with money. I mean, neither one of us did.
Right.
My parents did a good job with not letting us know the condition that we were in. But many times it was paycheck to paycheck. We always had food, but there was constant worry, stress, fear. Turn out the lights, eat all your food. I mean, the same way you did. It just, you know, we don't have money for this. We can't do that. Just a lot of can't haves, you know?
Can't have. Can't afford it. Can't have it. Be grateful for what you do have.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you wanted a new bike. But now here you are 30 years later and you're an adult. You don't want a new bike. You know what you want? You want a whole bunch of other stuff, like a trip. You can't take a vacation right now. Now, I'm not talking about money anymore. I'm talking about choices. See, when I talk about money all the time, I'm talking about getting rich. Look, getting rich is the first thing. Having choices comes after that. You can't have choices without money. Your kids can't go to the right schools. By the way, most schools suck. They're terrible. Nobody would defend that. Even people teaching in the schools would say the school sucks.
School sucks.
Okay? Your kids are not going to get the proper information and education they need. They're never going to get a world experience if you can never travel. So that's what we talk about. Me and Elena talk about, we don't talk about, can we buy another pair of Pradas? Even though she talks about that quite a bit.
No, I don't. That's not my brand. But
okay,
anyway.
Excuse me. Okay, so look, call in. We want to help you. 305-865-8668. 305-865-8668. We believe in marriage. We believe in partnership. And we believe in prosperity. And we believe you should have it. This is at Elena Cardone on Instagram.
Oh, yeah.
And me, you can find me anywhere. Okay.
Anywhere.
This month,
anytime,
I'm making a push
24/7.
This month. I'm making a push this month. Okay, to get people on my newest program, playbooktomillions.com is the website. Playbooktomillions.com. I'm literally going to teach people, you, how to become a millionaire and more.
Getting rich is not a fantasy. 500,000 families last year became millionaires, and over 80% of them are self-made. Look, are you tired of just getting by? Are you tired of worrying about money all the time? Have you given up on wealth as an option? What if you could get an exact strategy on how to get rich now? But we have that guide for you. Grant Cardone's Playbook to Millions tells you exactly how to become a millionaire and get rich. You're gonna learn everything about how to manage your personal finances, the never-before-seen wealth creation formula, how to create a millionaire mindset, how to make millions in business, the top sales secrets, the secrets to closing the sale, learning about follow-up, which is the greatest sales secret, how to create a 10x super life, and how to stay motivated on your way to millions. With over 35 hours of content, and for the first 2,000 people that register, you'll receive a hard copy of the Playbook to Millions ebook. This is the program to get you rich now. If you want to get rich, if you want to get out of where you are and make more money, get your playbook on how to get there. Sign up now at playbooktomillions.com. That's playbooktomillions.com. In your neighborhood with a lasting impression. A professional landscape can deliver that and more. And the man to bring it to you is Steve Griggs. Awarded the National Best of Hows in Client Satisfaction in 2016 with clients such as Dr. Oz and the Palisade Center Mall in West Nyack, Steve Griggs is New York's best landscape designer. This isn't landscape design, this is lifestyle design. For more information, visit SteveGriggsDesign.com. That's SteveGriggsDesign.com. Credit affects every aspect of life. How's yours? At Safe Credit Solutions, we dedicate our lives to ensuring you can get the life you want. Safe Credit Solutions are FICO certified consultants, and we are trained to be immediately at your service, find solutions, and repair your credit. Our goal is to grow your credit, add stability, and accomplish the goals you want for your life. With month-to-month services and live monitoring of our progress, we can get results for you within 30 to 45 days. Visit SafeCreditSolutions.com. That's SafeCreditSolutions.com to get a free credit consultation from our expert team. And let's get you on the path to repairing your credit today. That's SafeCreditSolutions.com.
Woo!
Welcome back to the G&E Show. This is Adelena Cardone. I'm Grant Cardone. We're here to talk to you about what happens when marriage and business collide. Today's topic is why your family must increase their bust.
No.
I mean, get rich.
Get on the same playbook to millions.
Playbook to millions, okay? And how to get rich and why you should get rich and can anyone get rich and why?
Why? Dude, why should they get rich?
So you can have choices.
Okay.
It's not for the money, folks. It's not for the status. It's not because somebody's going to give you a little plaque.
It's for protection.
No, it's for choices. It's for choices.
Yeah, I guess so. But choices. I think protection, like unexpected, protection. Your parents, something happens with them or your child,
then you get
or
a
this
choice.
Or that, you get a
you
choice.
Get a choice. Hey, I want to send them to the local hospital, okay, so they can sit and wait. Or maybe you got a vet, maybe you got one of your parents or your cousins or uncles is a vet. You want to send them to the VA, dude? Or you want to send them to a private hospital where somebody can actually take care of them today, not 300 days from now?
Mm.
They're called choices,
mm-hmm.
okay? Choices cost money, okay? You go to the restaurant. Your choices are limited to how much money you got, or...
Don't you be ordering that Wagyu.
How much... I ain't ordering Wagyu anyway. Or how much confidence you have about money, okay? If you don't have confidence about money, you can have money and still not be able to spend it. That's how I spent the first 45 years of my life. I had money, but no confidence to spend money, no confidence to get new money. That's why your mommy and daddy, why are you looking at me like that?
Because you're so handsome.
Okay, because I take care of you, dude.
Mm-hmm,
I take care
mm-hmm,
of you, don't I?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Better than you ever thought, right?
Yeah, you are.
Okay?
You're
better than I ever thought. I'm going to tell you something, man. You know how proud it makes me to know that I take care of her? That I came after her and said, hey, I'm going to take care of you, and that I do?
You
makes
do.
Me proud.
Yeah.
That I can take care of my two little girls and give them the best education possible? Makes me proud, man. Makes me proud. That's wealth. Okay? Got nothing to do with money. You guys understand?
Don't cry.
That's why you guys got to get rich. That's why I'm so freaking passionate. And that's why I keep pushing on this, even though it's unpopular. Because we get a lot of hate on this thing. Cardone's always talking about money and getting rich. Dude, you guys should get rich. Okay? It's not against the law. You would help your church out. You will help your community out. You'd be a great example for other people. Other families are going to be like, wow, man, that's awesome what you did. Oh, that's awesome, that nice fence you built around your house. Oh my God, that addition you put on your home. That's good for property taxes. You pay more taxes. You help out.
What is rich?
I think rich, I mean, I'll have to look up the word real quick. I don't think I've ever looked this word up before. Okay, rich, defined.
See, the problem I had, the minute I started to collect...
Having a great deal of money or assets, wealthy. Go ahead, Betty.
No, what I was going to say is one of the problems that I had, now granted I was in my 20s, but wow. When I started to get what I thought was money for myself,
yeah.
When I made six figures, I mean, like when I made over 100,000 at 20-something, I mean, I thought I was rich. And the problem is that's
what were you doing when you made the 100?
I was on USA High.
Okay. She had a recurring role.
And I did commercials at the same time. And I just, for that age, that was a lot of money for me. At least from where I came from, it was more than my parents had ever made.
Right.
And so, but the problem is when I made that, I spent it as soon as it came in. So, I started thinking,
She made money and spent it. That is not rich.
Yeah, I know. I started buying, cars and car parts and a house. And then when I'd go out to bars, I'd, treat all my friends to a round of drinks. Like, I just thought I was money bags.
That's not wealth. That's not wealth. That's spending, okay? So that's what most people do with money. And that's why most people end up not liking money. Because money, the new money starts to represent, I'm going to waste it again. Because you knew then.
No, I thought, what do you mean? What do you think
did
I meant?
I thought
I was doing the right thing. I was buying a house. I thought that's what you were supposed to do to have, an asset. The cars
I buy. Buying a house is not an asset, folks, okay? Here's the deal. We have been so screwed up in this country about money because institutions have had other ulterior motives. So the ARA, okay, the American Real Estate Association, huge organization. They have lots of lobbyists. They go to Wall Street. They go to Wall Street and the government and say, hey, we need to put a program to convince Americans to buy homes.
Mm-hmm.
It needs to be good. Mm-hmm. Why should we do that? Because if they lock down on that house, they're there forever and they'll provide a tax base and that'll be good for a city. It'll be good for the municipality of a city.
Ooh.
And then Wall Street said, how can we get on some of this house action? We'll lend them the money, man. We'll do a thing called a mortgage backed by a bond. We'll sell it to their grandmother, get the money from the grandmother, pay the grandmother a half a point, charge these people 4 or 5%, more than the banks can get. And dude, they got everybody all freaking jacked. A house is not an asset, folks. That's why I
want
you to
get.
That's
what I thought. I thought I was doing the right thing.
Because that's what her mommy and daddy taught her. Mm-hmm. Her mommy and daddy did not teach her how to get rich.
No.
Your Uncle G, the godfather of the new economy, the godfather of the new economy, on the G&E show every Wednesday, is going to teach you how to get rich. It's called playbookstomillions.com is the website. These are four of the books you get, plus a few more, okay? In case I'm not delivering enough. This, for the first 2,000 people, this is gonna come in a book that we're creating right now that's gonna be this thick. It's gonna sit in your library. We're working on the cover free. We're gonna include this in a $395 product. Give it to me, Robert, just so they can see the
killed it.
Now, this product right here by itself is gonna be $395. I'm gonna give this to the first 2,000 people that join us at playbooktomillions.com. It's 40 hours of live delivery in video and audio, plus ebooks, plus the first 2,000 people. It's only $495, by the way. Program's $4,985. It's $495. First 2,000 people get this bundle right here for free. I'll ship it for free, as long as it's in the U.S. Okay.
So wait, when we come back, though, I really need you to answer the question, what is rich?
Dude, rich,
I mean, I want a dollar amount. Yeah. Like, what is rich?
Rich is not having to depend on one flow of income any longer. It is wealth. It is streams. It is streams of prosperity coming into you that cannot be destroyed or disrupted.
Okay, we have to figure this out.
At 25 years old, I had one stream of income. So you know what happened when you got one stream of income?
Yeah, so did I. I had just the acting.
Right.
Yeah.
One stream. You're constantly worried about the one stream.
Yes, and I was all the time. And that's why I was up and down and up and down. I had money, I didn't have money. I had money, I didn't have money.
Okay. But if she'd have had, if she would have learned this in the beginning, take that one stream and start to add supplemental streams that are parallel, or what I talk about over and over in this program, I talk about symbiotic flows, okay? Now, Robert's in my office. He's gone from 45 grand to 90 grand to 135. He's got three streams of income.
Get out, that true? Damn.
So at his age, he's gonna make more money than you did back then with one show, but he's got three streams that are smaller than your one.
Yeah.
But when your one goes away, what happens?
The oil well is dry.
That would not be rich, okay? Now, I started with one stream when I was 25. Today, I have over 50 streams of income. I'm not bragging, I'm telling you. That's what you need to shoot for. Stay with us. The G&E Show, we're talking rich.
When it comes to knowing real estate investing, there's a lot to know. And it can be extremely overwhelming on how to get started. That's where the experts at King of Flips come in. Available right now is an exclusive real estate program, King of Flips University, that teaches you everything you need to know on how to invest, how to save money, and invest even with no money. Accessible anywhere at any time, let the industry experts teach you how to make millions in real estate. King of Flips University is a one-of-a-kind experience where you will be assigned a multi-million dollar investor coach to help you get started on knowing how to invest in real estate. Learn the right markets, learn the right signs, and get well on your way to becoming an expert in real estate investing. Visit kingofflips.com. That's kingofflips.com to get started right now.
Fall is always the moment when you have to redefine yourself. Easy is not part of success. Easy is not part of life. When I was 33 years old, I faced the lowest point in my life. I was broke. I was battling demons of women, finances, alcohol, and drug addictions. And here I stand in front of you in the top 1% of car salesmen in the United States. Quitting was never an option for me. I keep pushing for my son, for my dreams, and what I'm attempting to create for my own life. My name is Mark Jennison, and this is The Comeback Corner. I was a millionaire twice and lost it all twice. And now I'm here to show you what it takes to come back and stand in the face of adversity, even if that adversity is yourself. This show is designed to prove that no matter how far you fall, no matter how great the defeat or failure, there's always a comeback. There's always an opportunity to redefine yourself, redefine who you are, and come back stronger, better, and faster than before.
To learn more about Mark and his story, check out markjennison.com. That's markjennison.com.
We are back with the G&E Show. Thank you. I got my boy here, GC, who's always got my back.
This show every Wednesday, 12 p.m. Eastern Standard Time from Miami Beach Studio, Grant Cardone TV. We bring you a show called the G&E Show. It's about business and relationships when the two collide, when they commingle, when they start working together or working against one another, what are you gonna do? We're talking about
rich. Get your money right.
Why your family must get rich.
Did you define rich? So rich. Multiple streams of income. Do you have a set fee? I mean, you know, not fee, but do you have like a set number that like people can, like, if I have X in the bank, then I'm rich.
No,
you don't have that.
No.
That's for each individual to decide?
No, rich is abundance, man. It is prosperity. If you look it up in the dictionary, okay, the word rich was originally created in the dictionary, because I know a lot of you out there, and I'm seeing some of the posts and comments here. God, you know, God will take care of you. Dude, God ain't gonna take care of your money, folks, okay?
Look, God helps those who help themselves.
Yeah, exactly. I pray as much as anybody. I love prayer. I believe in prayer. God is not responsible for your economy. And shame the hell on you if you're praying to God for freaking economics, man. Mm. God's got his hand full with 7.3 billion people killing themselves every day. What do you think he's gonna do? He's trying to interrupt some freaking hurricane, some ISIS attack, or some guy that's at Whole Foods worried about it, whether he can buy a chai tea. Come on, man. Okay, English.
That's good.
The old English, 700 years ago, the word rich originally meant powerful.
Ooh.
Now, when I think of powerful, I think back of choices. Mm-hmm. I want choices, man. When you got choices, you have power. If I'm negotiating a deal, right now in there on a real estate deal, mm-hmm. a deal I've been trying to get down in Kindle.
Oh, I love that deal.
Okay. Every time the guy says, you interested? I just write back.
Yes.
They're greedy. They're greedy. Because I've already told him over and over I wanted to buy the deal.
Yeah.
So now they're starting to come back to me. Okay. So I'm being given choices here. When I can't buy what I want right here, then I start going out. When I can't buy anything where I'm at, what do I want? I want rich. Not money, baby. It isn't about money. It's about choices. When I want my kids to go to the right schools, or when we lived in California, we weren't getting what we wanted, move.
Mm-hmm.
It takes money to move, man. Choices. Okay? When you go on vacation, you don't want to go to the Holiday Inn mm-hmm. and eat the garbage food in the buffet that's free that morning. Why do you think it's free food, dude? Because it's garbage. Okay? When you guys go to Sandals because it's cheap, you went because of the price, man. You went because drink all you want, eat all you want. Dude, if you can drink all you want and eat all you want, is shit. Okay, I'm just saying, let's keep it real. You ought to be down the street at the Four Seasons. That's where you ought to be, or at the Ritz. Okay, where it is expensive, but you're not there. Why? Because you never made a decision to get your family rich. Get rich so you can have choices.
But really, you used to tell me the only time to go to the Four Seasons or to the Ritz is to be amongst other people that you might have a possibility to do business with.
No, that's why. You want to meet people. You want to meet people that have money, that have had success, that have had discipline in amassing, not one flow, not two flows, not three flows, but have businesses that are paying them over and over. These are the winners, folks.
Okay.
Okay, Shane from Texas.
I want to also ask you, can anyone do this?
Okay, let's ask Shane.
Okay.
Shane, what's up, buddy?
Nothing much. It didn't work, Grant. Thanks for having me on.
Good to have you here, man. By the way, rich also means containing a large amount, of something specified. A large amount. Huge amount. Okay? Could be love. I could be rich in love.
I'm rich in love.
You're rich in love with me
today? Yes, I am. Always.
We're rich in friends, too. We got a lot of friends.
Oh, we got friends around the world.
I got a lot of friends. You know, this week I picked up almost 300,000 new friends on Snapchat. Hey, what's up, brother, man? We friends, me and you, Shane?
Yeah, I actually added you on Snapchat this week.
And dude, I'm a little richer than I used to be, bro. Brother Shane, we rich, dog. Come on. Hey, man, what's rich to you, Shane?
The same thing you're saying. More than one source of income, at least seven. The average millionaire has seven sources of income.
He said the average
millionaire,
has at least seven. Dude, I could destroy seven and still have 50. How would you like to be there? I started with one little puny freaking stream. I couldn't get the stream any bigger either, man. You know why? Because I didn't know how. First thing I had to do was lose my damn mind. Quit thinking the way Elena was thinking. Okay, make money, blow it. Make money, blow it. Go ahead, brother. What's up? You got a question?
Yes, sir. I was actually calling. You were talking about the recession. My buddy and I are making our sales pitch next week for the biggest oil and gas company in Atlanta, Georgia. Man, it's big. We're business model we're presenting actually stands a chance for us to profit over $1,000 per employee that we can bring on during the construction phases of, you know, pipeline services and things of that nature. But with the recession you're talking about, could this be a bad time to be trying to start a business and get into bed with these oil and gas companies?
Dude, look, here's the deal, okay? Any time is a bad time to start a business.
However.
Because it's hard, bro. It's hard. I'm just telling you the reality of the situation, okay? Because yes. Because most people don't know what a business is. A business is transactions, not ideas. Transactions mean I need money coming into the business. And most people think, well, I started a business. Dude, no, bro, you opened a freaking office. That ain't a business, man. Okay?
Or you opened like your living room door and yeah, that's
yeah,
your
yeah,
office.
Yeah, I'm working from home on my computer. That ain't a business, dude. A business needs money. It needs money coming in, lots of money coming in. That's a good business. Most businesses actually own people, by the way. Okay. In fact, 3/4 of all businesses break even or lose money. I think it's 68%. 68% of all small businesses break even or lose money. That ain't a business, man.
Ooh,
that
no.
is a freaking punishment.
That's a detriment.
You could do that at somebody's job. I mean, a fairly popular guy was here in my offices one day, and he says, you know, if Robin's going to work for you for 44 grand, she should work for herself for 44 grand. I'm like, nobody should work for 44 grand. See, the first part of the theory doesn't work. Nobody should work for 44 grand because there's no money left over. So Shane, all I would tell you, man, is, bro, it's gonna be hard, bro.
But?
So you better know where you can pick up money this week. Because while you're building your business, you gotta eat. You gotta pay your bills. You need a plan, dude. You need a plan, a playbook to millions. You guys don't need a business plan. You need a playbook to millions. Everybody's got
We've
a business
done the math
plan.
Backwards.
Huh?
We got it. We've done the math backwards, man. 10 employees. 10 employees. We'll profit $1,000 a day on. But once we scale to 20.
But who's got your money, dude? Who's got your money? Who's got the money? Who's going to give you money for that?
It's a 60-day turnaround, set percentages on return investment. Our investors right
who's
now
got the money, though, man? Who? Give me a name.
It's my best friend, Cecil. He's actually my investor. He's got the money.
Okay.
Put us in. We're a glorified payroll. Is how this works. We cover the payroll and expenses. They pay us $2,500 per employee, and our payroll actually goes out $750 a day to these guys. So the profit margins are stupid. After Social Security's matched, Medicare's matched, equipment for the day and week and month, all of these things are accounted for. This is a set exact profit margin, no risk on the money. And they cut a check every 60 days for what we cover on this payroll.
Dude, you need to get off the phone with me and go start hustling that deal then, bro.
Oh, look, it is. Folks, we're meeting with them Tuesday morning next week, brother. That's why I want to thank you, because we got off our ass. We are about it. We did the math.
Come on, man. Let's get it, man. Let's get it, okay? Awesome, Shane. That's great. Hey, so folks, look, when the cards are good, just keep asking for cards, okay? There's going to be a time when those cards go cold, you understand? When the freaking dice are hot, man, you just keep rolling them. Don't drink. You know, you don't need to parade with everybody. Everybody's like, oh my God, oh my, dude, shut up. Give me those dice. Dog, when you're rolling hot dice, when you're getting good cards, when things are rolling, when the window's open, baby, how much can you shove through that window? Kevin, Pennsylvania, bro, what's up? Kevin, how you doing, man? Thanks for watching the G&E show.
Hey, thank you.
You did the summary. Talk to me, man, what's up?
Hey, so I currently have, I watch your show pretty often, but I have an investor. I'm a personal trainer, and we're starting a small business startup together. I just wanted to see what your opinion was, or advice, criticism, anything like that you could give on small businesses that are training-oriented. Any advice at all, honestly, would be appreciated.
Well, man, first of all, you guys need a big think, okay? Most people get into business and they think, man, if we just make $10,000 a month, my God, that'd be more money than we've ever made before. Your company will start because it will start and stop right there. This is how I started my first company. Man, I was making 100 grand at my old job. If I could just make $8,000 a month, this is what I did. If I could make $8,000 a month, I replaced my other income. Now, what did I just do? I went from a job that already paid me to a new job that might pay me. Said, oh, I'm going to go from this to that. I'm back to one flow again, but I'm back to one maybe flow when I had one secure flow. That's the problem.
Secure.
Okay? Yeah, I had a secure flow. Now, this is what happens to people. Because here's what's going to happen to most people. Most people, because of the way we think, the flow is going to go down. It's going to get smaller. Because of the think, it didn't have to, but because of the way we were thinking about this last job, when you move to this job, and this is what I said to myself, man, if I could just make what I was making at my last job. Dude, if you keep everything stable, there's a universal fact in the world. If everything stays flat, it falls. Okay. If all your decisions are, I'm just going to keep doing what I've been doing, gravity will pull it down. We live on an economic planet. Okay. The major gravity on this planet is economics. So you want affluence. You need to think about, how do I surge? How do I get increments?
More of the good things that you were doing that got you there. Yeah, you have to do more. You can't keep it the same or it's going to go down.
And now that you're a no-name, nobody knows you, you're just starting up, you don't have the confidence, you don't have the customers, you don't have the flows, you're going to need a lot of big things. So you need, this is what I would tell everybody to do. Dude, when you make this transition, you got to build a business plan that 10x, whatever you were thinking. So if you were making 100, you gotta be like, I gotta build $1 million business here. If you're not gonna build $1 million business in a short period of time, do not make this transition. Stay where you're at, because that's what's gonna happen. Read the definitions of rich.
Rich, having a great deal of money or assets, wealthy.
Affluent, moneyed, well off,
plentiful,
well-to-do,
abundant,
prosperous,
generating
opulent,
wealth, valuable.
Okay,
that's good.
In the dough, in the money, loaded, flush, stinky
having
rich,
in large amounts,
filthy rich, well-heeled, made of money, sumptuous,
so
opulent, luxurious, luxury, deluxe, lavish, gorgeous, splendid, magnificent, costly. Look,
so even I could have made money back then?
Dude,
with my,
you could have
what
made,
could have I
baby,
done?
You were making 100 grand 20 years ago.
Wow.
That's like 250,000 bucks today. Might be more than that, might be like 300,000. You were freaking in the dough, okay? So that money, I mean, look what I've done with your mom's money.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah, but I couldn't have done that by myself. I didn't know anybody like you to say, hey, can
you didn't
I
know anybody.
30 grand?
She didn't know anybody like me because she never made this decision.
That's true.
Right? She decided to be an actress. So everybody she knew was actresses. You guys need to make GC your godfather of money. Okay? You need to connect with me, man. You need to be with me every day, every week, every month, between now until you're freaking stupid rich. You gotta pick who you're gonna be with. I made this decision when I was 26 years old. My brother came to me with a Barron's magazine. I've told you this story before.
And he says, look,
dude, you need to start reading about wealthy people. I said, man, I hate that magazine. I tried to read that newspaper before. He's like, you don't understand what you're reading. Learn how to learn how to study, read that magazine. Because that's where all the money's at. The money's in reading, following, not copulating with, but not mimicking. Yeah, mimicking, learning, surrounding, getting mentorship, copulating.
I know, I'm like,
mentoring by people that have created wealth, man. The kind of wealth that I can do what I want, when I want, how I want, go where I want, play how I want. Claudia from Jersey, New Jersey.
Bring it on.
Hey.
Yes,
hey.
Claudia, how you doing? Claudia, what do you think about getting rich, my friend?
Oh my God, it's the most amazing thing in the fucking world. It is the most gratifying thing you can do.
Well, what do you know about it? Sounds like you know a lot about getting rich.
Oh, I do. I know a lot about losing money. At 25 years old, I lost $500,000 on my house, on my cars. Economy went down and everything just slipped away from my hands because I was immature. I didn't know how to handle things. But with age and experience and self-education and the University of Mr. Cardone has taught me and my husband so much. And we are building our businesses. We are strong. We are selling. We are cold calling. We are making money. And we are so happy. And I just wanted to let you guys know that it is true. Decisions are so good when you have money. Mm. You can make the best decisions of your
because
life.
Because she's a good person.
Yeah.
You know, if she was a criminal and she had money, she wouldn't be rich. She's just a criminal with a bunch of money.
Right.
But if you take a good person, hey, Claudia, that's great. Give your husband my love, all right? Look, if you're a good person and you add money, you got a good person with choices. If you're a bad person with money, you're gonna lose it all anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? It's not like you're ever gonna be happy, you're never gonna help anybody, you're just gonna die, old criminal. Everybody's gonna say you were a criminal. Nobody's gonna say that about me.
Mm-mm.
Nobody's gonna talk about my money when I'm done.
No.
You know what they're gonna say? Let's say I died today. What would people be saying about me immediately?
Your legacy, your wealth of information.
Dude, that guy worked, that guy hustled, that guy helped, gave him himself.
That guy, yeah, changed my life. I hear that every day. People send me success stories.
So look, I want to help you. I know Elena wants to help you, and she does help you, by the way. She's behind the scenes helping you, but let me tell you something. Every day, she's pushing me to help more people. She's like, look, you can help people, Grant. You talk to people the way they want to be talked to. You have simple advice that people can actually hold on to.
Because I wish I had had it before I knew you.
Why don't you take advice from me when I give it to you?
Yeah, I do. Keep on the other thing. Sidetracked you. Get back on track.
She never listens to me. But she does encourage me a lot to like, hey, do more. You can do more. She never, ever, ever. First of all, nobody Snapchats more than I do. Does anybody?
We'll all agree on that.
Okay.
Okay, you get that.
She never says, can you please put that up? Never in 12 years has never said, can you put that up?
No.
Maybe once. Maybe twice. Maybe.
Like, just don't walk into the bathroom like when I'm in there. Okay? Let's just draw a line.
Yeah. Never. She's never said that. Because she's like, she knows that it makes me rich inside. To help people, man. Yeah. This is my legacy and my life purpose. I know for sure my life purpose is to help as many people as possible. So this month we came out with this playbook called Playbooks to Millions, okay? It's Playbook to Millions. How personal finance starts with personal finance first, then wealth creation formula, then the creating the $1 million mindset, and then how to make millions in business. And I'm gonna give you top sales secrets, secrets to closing the sale, follow-up, the greatest business or sales secret, 10X Super Life,
woo!
And 100 Ways to Stay Motivated. This is $4,900 worth of programs for $495. Plus, if that's not enough, if I didn't give you enough already, the first 2,000 people...
Plus this free pen!
The first 2,000 people... I'll give you the pen, too. First 2,000 people are going to get this for your library.
The black binder.
Okay, it's not the black... It won't be black. It hadn't finished. It's Playbooks to Millions course. It's a monster packet, okay? All in one place to put up in your library and to remind you, to anchor down. So you got this every day. You can't not think about this, okay? It's going to be like, dude, this is my Playbook to Millions. Because the more Elena was thinking about her money when she was 20 years old, if she'd have been thinking about that money, she'd have had
it. I was thinking, I just did the wrong choices. I could have invested $30,000
You were thinking about your money.
Whistle.
You weren't thinking about becoming a millionaire. Oh. You were thinking about money. You weren't thinking about becoming a millionaire. If you had this in your office every day and had to look at it, man, you are the things you surround yourself with, folks. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Okay.
You know, back in the 70s, late 60s, everything was the peace movement. Peace-minded, peace. Peace! For 10 years, all we did was move through this peace movement. Okay? Nobody was thinking about money. Everybody was thinking about peace and love, man. Let me tell you what we're about to go through in the 21st century. 16.
You're scaring me.
Everybody's going to be talking about money, folks. I'm telling you. This is happening right here, right now. Okay. I'm on the front edge of it. I'm not telling you to buy gold or silver. I'm not telling you that I wouldn't do that. I'm telling you, you got to produce money. You have to learn about money, and you have to learn about prosperity and wealth and rich so that you can take care of your wife, you can take care of your kids, so you can have choices, okay? The new program is called Pathway to Millions. I want to answer some questions
Pathway?
Here.
Pathway?
I'm
Pathway?
Sorry. Playbook to Millions. Playbook to Millions. That's how new it is. Mm-hmm. We're just finishing. We're wrapping it up, okay? Money, 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 says Jennifer. Jennifer Nucce. Thank you, Jennifer, for watching the show today. Sherry Amy. That's why I hang out with Grant.
Amy. That's Amy.
Amy, okay? I can't read all the comments coming in. I want to give a call out to everybody that shared the stream. Guillermo Vasquez,
Guillermo.
Thank you. Guillermo Harpreet Singh from India, looks like from India. Aaron Escobedo.
Escobedo.
Sales guy here.
Oh, what's he doing watching? What's he doing watching? Dude, get back to work.
Get back to work.
David Collier, Hector Ocho, thank you. Tara Bufo Drews. By the way, if you have any questions, folks, post them in comments. One of my staff asked me yesterday, dude, after these shows, like, how do you actually go sit down and respond to all these comments, okay?
He does.
800 comments. She knows. I responded to him.
He Snapchats everybody back.
So I literally sit there and Snapchat people back.
And he's like, how am I going to get through? I have 800 Snapchats that are waiting for me.
I don't know how to do it. But
he tries.
I'm going to keep doing it.
You do about 50 or 60.
I'm going to keep doing it as long as I can do it. Valerie D says, love this power couple. Valerie, thanks for watching the show. Nathan Hammock, thank you for watching the show. And thank you for sharing, buddy. I appreciate it.
Salud.
What do you want to say? What can you say, Elena?
What do I learn today? Why is the importance of money for choices?
Choices.
What is rich? It's multiple flows of income. Can anyone?
Some of which should be indestructible, by the way.
Can an artist become rich?
Sure, absolutely.
Okay. Well, obviously, with this wealth of information. And so that's what I got out of it.
George Clooney's rich in fans, right? He's rich in homes.
Yeah.
I don't know if he's got any money.
You would think he does.
I don't know. I know this. I would trade my financial condition for most $20 million actors. Because what they do, they earn $20 million.
Yeah,
they
like look at Nicolas Cage.
Look at Michael Tyson. Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
We know firsthand.
They earn more money than I ever earned, but they didn't do the right things with it.
Yeah.
That can be you or can not be you. Most people never even earn enough money, number one. Just never earn enough money. Number two, the other half don't know what to do with the money they have. So they send it off to Wall Street, put it in a 401k and can't ever get to it. They just get old. Most people just get old and then find out when they die, damn, the guy had a little money. Dude, that ain't rich. That's a prisoner. Okay. All right. So appreciate each of you watching the show. My name's Grant Cardone. This is at Elena Cardone.
Maybe one of these episodes we will touch base. I don't know. Honestly, this is a little bit of a braggy thing, but we don't really have jealousy issues. But I know there's other jealousies too, not just of other people, but of friends, family, work, the workplace. You know, one gets in shape, one doesn't. You know, all kinds of jealousies.
Oh, you trying to do the jealousy thing, huh?
Well, I'm just saying, one of these episodes, if it's, requested, maybe we'll confront it.
No, we're not talking about jealousy on this show. You guys got your hands full with other stuff to do, man. Look, on the playbook,
2 millions, hear me out. Yeah. Can you see why maybe another person would have to deal with, like, the other person being more dedicated to the job than the partner and how to deal with that? Can that be a reality?
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. I'm not just talking about...
jealousy, that's stupidity. That's stupid. Jealousy.
That's what I'm talking about. You know what jealousy is, by the way. It's not just being jealous of like another female. It could be jealous of work. It could be jealous of anything.
But a jealous person is self-centered. Well, who are they thinking about?
Or their insecurities.
They're poor. If you're thinking about yourself every day, you're poor.
So let's go.
Oh, you're thinking about it. We're covered in another topic. It sounds like you have a lot to say about it.
You're
talking about yourself, okay? I'll tell you this too. On this topic, the middle class is basically a bunch of selfish people that have tricked themselves to think they're generous. You ain't generous. You got nothing to give. You can't give anything, man. If you gave what you had, you'd be broke. That's not generous. See, the people that actually create wealth and give to charities and communities and are actually able to stroke a check, they did the work, man. They put the discipline in to create enough affluence to be able to give this and drive that big car or two big cars and send their kids to the best schools and put their name on a freaking hospital. Dude, that takes a tremendous amount of discipline. No reason to hate on it.
Yes, it does.
Hating on that, being jealous of that, is basically you trying to make sense of why you haven't done all that. I want to help you do all that because you're not any more talented or less talented than I am or Elena is. She married good, let's face it. She married good.
I did.
Okay?
I married good.
And I had to talk her into it.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. All right. Sandra says, you need to have haters, Grant. Some people don't like you because your strength reminds them of their weakness.
Mm.
Dude, that's strong. Mm. That's strong. Mm. Frank Pardita, I just lost it. Grant, you're a blessing and legend. You're legendary in the making. Thank you, Frank. Oh, you love that word.
Legend.
Marquis says, you're saving lives. Matthew says, oh my God, yes. There is no nobility in poverty, says Devandra from India.
There is no nobility in poverty.
And by the way, poverty. The middle class is a nice, shiny, polished up word for poverty.
What did Sabrina say? Middle class is rich people who are really poor?
Yeah.
Yeah, I love
that's my
that.
Six-year-old telling. I said, that's baby, what's the middle class? Oh, that would be rich people. What?
She said, that's rich people who are really poor.
That's poor people.
No, rich people who are really poor.
People that think they're rich that are really poor.
Right.
I don't know, I have to find the video.
Yeah.
All right, look, we want to help you, okay? I'm not condemning anybody. I'm not making anybody wrong. I'm just telling you the truth, okay? You got to call the alcoholic. You got to call the drug addict. You got to call the guy cheating on his wife. Dude, you're cheating on your wife. Okay, you got to call the guy with the gambling a problem. Dude, you got a problem, bro, okay? People that don't pay you back, you need to call them deadbeats. People that are broke, you just need to tell them, dude, you're broke. and you don't need to be. I want to help you. Playbooktomillions.com, playbooktomillions.com. First 2,000 people are going to get this binder. First 2,000 are going to get this binder. Oh, yeah. First 2,000 are get this binder. That's all we're printing. Grab it. This is going to be $3.95 when we're done with the first 2,000. I'm giving it to you for free, plus 40 hours of live webcasts and all these beautiful ebooks. Okay, God bless you. Be great. Get rich. You deserve it.
Yeah, Elena, you do.
Elena, take us away, baby.
Okay. Stick and stay is bound to pay. We
Stick
love you.
Stick with it.
Peace. Peace out, man.